In this video, we're going to show you how to configure your Schneider EZ9 compact multi-row consumer unit with an SPD, main switch, RCBOs and AFDDs on the top row. This is a first for me, a compact multi-row consumer unit. We take the lid off. What's the first thing you're going to show me, Rick?
Yeah, so what I'm going to show you is if we just back off ever so slightly the screws on the DIN rail and slide that to the left, it will then allow me to remove the DIN rail quite easily.
Okay, by removing that, I can see there's four holes I could put in the back, which makes it easy to bring my cables in and start that dressing process. And when that rail goes back on there, I can see on this side and the other side, there's two little nibs there. What are those nibs for?
Yeah, that's just to stop the MCBs or breakers from falling off the edge. So when I'm popping the lid back on, it's easy for it to go back on. There's nothing getting in the way.
Yeah, it stops them sliding around with a full set in the bottom. So we put our SPD in on our main switch, and the device for the SPD, so we've got a breaker there as well. You see on the right hand side the kit, so they're in position. So we're going to then look at working on the top of the board. Well, the top of the board's going to house our AFDDs, but I look at those and they're not AFDDs.
No, they're terminal blocks then, so that's what connects the bottom to the top.
Okay, so we'll be bringing our line and neutral tails into there and then bringing them across to our AFDDs. Now we're going to put five in for this process. We're only going to use three in another video when we actually make those connections. So they pop into there, and there's a really clever way of connecting them to the supply now, isn't there?
Now the AFDDs are in place, I can introduce the comb bus bar.
Okay, comb bus bar. So we've got line and neutral in both of those. I can see what it looks like, a comb. And that sits on top of the AFDDs, as well as the terminal block where the line and neutral tails will come into it as well. As you're holding it into place, Rick, we're not going to do it up now with a torque screwdriver, are we?
No, we're just going to hold them in place effectively.
Okay, and perhaps do that at the end when we can go through each screw systematically in order to get to the right torque setting. Now all our components are in place, we can start putting the links in. So this is the neutral link from the bottom of the double pole switch to the neutral bar, and it's important you get these in the right way round, isn't it?
Yeah, because as you see there, the rounded end will go into the neutral bar, and the flat rectangular end here will go into the double pole isolator.
Okay, so that double pole switch is not polaritised, so there isn't a line and neutral label on it, because it can go on the left or the right hand side of the board and it would swap position depending on where you installed it. So once that neutral's in, we can then maybe concentrate on perhaps looking at that SPD kit next.
The kit comes with pre-manufactured cables, which make installation very simple.
Okay, so it's going into the bottom of the isolator to pick up the neutral for the SPD. So we've got to make sure they're in correctly before we tighten those up. So that brings the neutral across.
The other end of that is now connected to the Type 2 SPD. So we'll now introduce the line cable into the top of the 20 amp MCB, which we will then loop across to the line terminal of the SPD.
And to finish off now, we'll just put the protective conductor into the top, and then that will be dressed and into the earth bar. It is long enough to work, whether it be on the left-hand side, it is now, you see it's a short position in order to get to the earth bar, so we can terminate it into there. But if it was on the right-hand side, obviously that length will help you get from the right-hand side back to that earth bar. Confession time, I think it is, Rick?
It is, yeah. I actually cut the buzz bar to the correct length. It was the safety shield, which might have been a smidge too small.
So we had to trim it down in order to fit into the board, but obviously you did a little bit too much trimming on the safety guard, so you're back in to get it to right length. So it just needs to overhang a little bit each side, obviously, so you can't touch that bar. And if you look now, we've actually swapped it over to show you the configuration when the SPD main switch and the device for the SPD is on the right-hand side. You can see the protective conductor now is long enough to reach that earth bar as stated before, and we've just fitted that buzz bar into the bottom of it there.
Next one out of the cable kit is the line conductor. And on this one we have two rectangular ends, one which is going to pop in to the bottom of the double pole isolator here.
That's important when you put those in that you seat it so it lays flat. You wouldn't want it side on in order to get the maximum surface area when you're tightening up. We're nipping it down here because obviously the buzz bar is going to go into the same position. And then the top one goes into one of these terminal blocks. Is it important which one it goes into?
Yeah, we need to make sure that it goes into the right-hand terminal block. As we previously showed, the buzz bar is polaritised.
Okay, so that will pick up the line connection. We will put some stickers on there that will say neutral and line to make it pretty obvious of which ones they needed to go into.
Next out of the pack is a neutral conductor again, and if you take a look at these again, the ends are round and rectangular in shape.
So the round one's now going to go into the neutral bar, and we're going to choose to put it next to the link that came from the bottom of the double pole switch, and then the other end is going to be located into the terminal block at the top, so we can pick the neutral up for our AFDDs.
I found them stickers, Gaz. I've only gotten stuck them on them terminal blocks.
Yeah, thanks for that, Rick. So that's the internal wiring for our configuration done. SPD main switch and the fuse for the SPD at the bottom and the AFDDs at the top. So now we can bring in our overcurrent protection devices, and we've chosen for all our circuits to be on RCBOs. Now I like this bit. Clipping a device onto a dim rail and hearing that sound of it making its connection is quite satisfying to me. But next up is the functional earth. So you got any top tips about identifying them, Rick?
Yeah, so each functional earth, I generally put a mark with a pen, so it makes it simple for me to know whereabouts it is in the board.
So that's circuit number two. Does this make this one circuit number three? I think I've got your rhythm here. So with them all marked up then, you can bunch them together with this tie wrap. But when you get to the other end for terminating, those marks are going to come back to identify which in the earth bar each of those fly leads go into.
Yeah, that's it. So as you can see, as I zip tie them together and then I dress them neatly within the board, once I get round to the other side, I know which lead corresponds with which mark.
It's almost any excuse with you, isn't it, to get the ferrule crimping tool out. This is the Nipex neck strip. So you're going to put a plain ferrule on the end of this?
Yeah, it's a brilliant tool, is that. Comes in handy, especially for cutting, crimping and also stripping. So I've just popped on a little plain ferrule on the end there, and then we'll place it within the earth bar afterwards.
Oh, there's something quite satisfying about this, though, isn't there? Oh, ferrule crimping tool done, and then it can just be popped in. Obviously, we're not going to tighten these down too much because obviously the circuit CPC will join them at some point as well. It doesn't seem fair just to show you the neck strip just the once in this video, so we're back out with it again in order to shorten the neutral fly leads from the RCBOs. But you're not going to use a plain ferrule this time, are you?
I'm not, no. I'm going to switch it up and I'm going to use an insulated ferrule this time around.
And here's my favourite bit. In it goes, and there is something immensely satisfying about doing that before obviously it can be popped and dressed into the neutral bar. Nice to see you taking your time to dress your cables within the consumer unit before you're onto that bus bar, but that looks familiar.
This one I think I've already fessed up to, though.
Is that the one where we've obviously got the outer insulator a bit short, which we replaced earlier on in the video? So this is not the one that we use at the end of the video. This is just the one that we obviously could see there. We could see the copper that you left hanging out the side, can't we? Good work, Rick. So that's the first time I've seen a rail board being assembled, and we chose to have a SPD main switch and RCBOs on our bottom rail, and on the top rail we chose to have the AFDDs, and I think it looks absolutely fantastic. In this video, me and Rick have shown you how to configure your Schneider EZ9 compact multi-road consumer unit, but as I look at this one, it looks remarkably like it's been wired. If you want to see how we got on doing that, check out the video over there.